What's up, Reid Temple fam? Let's get into this week's announcements. Are you enjoying 31 days of prayer? This week's focus is love. On Sunday, January 15th, we will have a special prayer service during our 9:30 a.m. service. All month long, you can visit our prayer room located in the lobby. For more information, visit reidtemple.org/31days. This year, we are aiming higher in God. Check out Pastor Whitlock's monthly sermon topics that will help us all go higher in 2023. Let's get excited, Reid Temple. Today's the day we've all been waiting for. We're kicking off Above the Tithe. In 2019, we launched the Debt Free for Thee campaign, and in spring 2022, we began implementation of the strategic goal to eliminate the building's primary mortgage over the next 2 years. Join this faith in God journey. Between now and February 5th, we're asking you to pray and seek God's face as to how you will participate in Above the Tithe. We're asking every member to commit, sacrifice, and give. Calling all January and February babies, you're invited to CLC's birthday celebration on Saturday, January 21st, 2023, from 11 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. For more information, visit reidtemple.org/events. Attention, Reid Temple. Join us for our official board meeting Monday, January 23rd at 7 p.m. via Zoom. Register to attend at reidtemple.org/events. Reid Temple, in partnership with Capital Area Food Bank, presents Drive-Thru Food Distribution at Reid Temple, Saturday, January 21st, from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Come get your supplies while they last. Distributions take place on the third Sunday of each month. That's a wrap for this week's announcements. And please, let's continue to build the beloved community together.
Hello, and welcome to the Reid Temple Online Worship Service. We're glad to be at Reid Temple, and so glad you decided to join us. Thank you for worshiping with us.
2022, and now I'm not going to stop in 2023. I love to praise his name. Amen. Happy New Year, Reid Temple. Happy New Year, those who are watching on the internet. It's 2023. Put all that stuff that happened in 2022 down. Come on. Let's go. Oh, y'all sound feel like y'all don't want to go yet, huh?
Ooh, I love to praise him.
Proclamation. What is today? God's salvation. And so what shall we do? Come, let us enter into his courts with praise. Amen. With praise. With praise. It's good. It's good. It's good. Our call to worship. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. For a day in thy courts is better than a thousand. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good. Those that are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Blessed, 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 blessed are they that dwell in thy house. Lord, I have loved thy habitation, the place where thy honor dwelleth. For the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Now let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Now all together, oh, sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Sing his praises. Now, let's remain standing and sing our congregational hymn. Amen. Amen.
Amen. How many of you know that prayer changes things? How many of you know that prayer changes things? Come on, our pastor is preaching on prayer this month. And so just a little talk with Jesus will make it all right. Anybody know that? Come on, put your hands together.
Yeah.
And he will answer by and by. And we know that when we go to him, there truly is a little fire burning, because we know that he will make it all right. Amen, amen. Let us go to the throne of grace and mercy. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. For here we are, oh God. We looked over the precipice of 2022 into 2023, and here we are, Father God, on the first day, the first Sunday of 2023, Lord God, and we thought it not robbery to come into your house to give you thanks and praise, not only for last year, Lord God, but for an expectancy of this year. Lord, we remember to look forward. We remember how you kept us last year. We remember your faithfulness. We remember your mercy, Lord God. We remember your grace. We remember the healing. We remember the strength, oh Lord God. And because of what we remember, Lord God, it gives us the onus to be able to push forward, Lord God, to remember to move forward, Lord God, knowing, Lord God, that you are the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And if you did it on yesterday, Lord God, you're going to do it on today. And so, Father, we just want to pause to say thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Father, for forgiving us of our sins, those things that we did which did not please you, Lord God. Thank you that your word said that if we confess our sins, that you're faithful and just to forgive us, and that you would cleanse us from unrighteousness, oh Lord God, and that you would have us to be back in right relationship with you. So, Father, we thank you for the promises on which we are standing, promises which cannot fail, oh Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, even now for this great congregation, those that are here in the temple and those that are watching across the various platforms, Lord God. We're thanking you, Father God, that our hearts are turned towards you, Lord God. We're looking up, not at our problems, Lord God, because our problems are insignificant compared to you, because there is nothing impossible with you. We have learned, oh Lord God, that all things work together for the good of those that are called according to your purpose, oh Lord God. And Father, as we sit here in anticipation, Lord, we thank you for Pastor Whitlock, Lord God, and for First Lady Reverend Mia Whitlock, Lord, because we know that they have fasted and prayed together and that they have sought you for what the direction is for this branch of Zion for 2023. So, Lord God, revive and refresh him, because he's been on a mission for these last few days, encouraging us, Lord God. So strengthen him, Lord God, in his inner man, Lord God. Anoint him afresh, and Lord God, anoint our ears to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to the church. Turn our hearts from stone into flesh so that your words may be put on our hearts, Lord God. Our hands, oh Lord God, the word declares that when we are with you, that whatsoever we put our hands to shall prosper. But let it prosper we know it's going to prosper in the right thing. Our footsteps are ordered by you, oh Lord God. Father, thank you for all that you've done and for all that you've yet to do. And thank you, Lord God, for the purpose of today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Happy New Year, everybody. Let's stand for the word of God this morning, the reading of it. And we're coming from the book of James, the 5th chapter. Turn with me as we hear what thus saith the Lord on the first day of one of the greatest years in your life. Let's go. Therefore, confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed, because the prayer of the righteous person is powerful and effective. For example, Elijah was a human being just as we are, and he prayed earnestly that it would not rain. And it did not rain on the land for 3.5 years. But then he prayed again. Somebody say, pray again. Somebody say, pray again. And when he prayed again, the heavens gave the rain and the earth produced its crops. Somebody say, glory to God. Prayer changes things. We'll be right back.
seen nothing yet. If you thought God blessed you before, you ain't seen nothing yet. Come on, give God glory. Come on, if you expect him to do something bigger and greater, come on, get on your feet and give God glory. You ain't seen nothing yet. Tell your neighbor, it gets better. It gets better. You ain't. Come on, it's 2023. You ought to enter the new year with a praise. Hallelujah. Last year's praise won't do it. Because morning by morning, new mercies. Morning by morning, new blessings. Hallelujah. Hallelujah in the house. Praise the Lord. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. I would ask if all first-time visitors, if you would stand for us and remain standing. Any first-time visitors in the house, please stand and remain standing. Amen, amen. Keep standing, keep standing, keep standing. Amen. Our greeters are coming to put something in your hand. If you would kindly fill that out and drop it off in the offering basket or after service in the lobby. Amen. We would greatly appreciate it. And those online, we welcome you. Go ahead and put in the chat that you are visiting with us. And an online attendant will reach out to you. Amen. And because you are here, we got something for you. Amen. Amen. The good members of Reid Temple, come on and stand up and let's sing. We're glad to be at Reid Temple.
Put your hands together. It's offering time. Amen. It's offering time. We had a good time last night with our first fruits offering, the first offering for 2023. You may have missed it, but this is your opportunity. This is your opportunity to give your best offer for 2023. Because as we grow closer to thee, we want to make sure we give our best. Be obedient unto God. Love God because God has done so much for us, brought us through 2022. And now we're perched and prepared for 2023 to do our best in God. So bring your best offering. Release your offering unto God. Release your gift unto God. Don't hold it back. God didn't hold back on you this morning by waking you up. We want to release our gift to God. Let me pray. Dear God, I pray now. You said that don't even come to the altar. First, you make amends, fix your relationship with one another. Then come to the altar with your gift. Bring your best gift. And then he said, I promise to bless you. God, help us to do the right thing, to be obedient unto God, to do as God has instructed us to do. And you said you give it back 10, 50, 100 fold. So now, God, we believe you and we're convinced if what we have is because you gave it to us and in our giving, we glorify you. That's our prayer in Jesus' name. Now, for those of you online, please text to Reid Temple to 45777. For those of you who are here, follow the direction of the ushers as we hear some giving music for 2023. Come on, let's give. Everybody rise. For you who are at home, why don't you rise as you've given your offering over the line. All things come of thee, O Lord. on, you ain't done yet. Come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, Jesus. Come on, man, Jesus. 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 Jesus, how precious is his name in 2023. How precious is his name. Let us pray. Dear God, it's a new year, it's a new season, it's a new day, it's a new beginning, it's a new you in you. God, preach through me so that they may hear a new revelation from you. Pushes us through all the challenges that we experienced in 2022. God, you came to say COVID-19 ain't got nothing on Christ. A mask does not block the Messiah's image in our head. Now, God, give me power to preach. Much power, much preaching. Little prayer, no power. If you pray for the pastor, then I promise he'll preach. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise all over the house of the Lord. Please rise as you hear word from the Lord. There's a word from the Lord. There's a word from the Lord. I'm just so pleased to look at those who are here. You were here. Some of you, put your hand up. How many were here last night? Come on, lift your hands up. Look around. Amen. Give God praise for those who came back after 4 or 5 hours. I couldn't get to sleep until about 3 o'clock this morning. My wife literally threw water in the bed. Amen. I'm soaking wet for the Holy Ghost. Take a look at the text. The Bible says in the book of James, and we're going to read this together. You know we like to read together. Let us read. Therefore, confess your sins to each other. Pray. The effective fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. I want to know if there's anybody here on a journey to be a righteous person. Come on, give God a glory praise. Our sermonic subject this morning, unleashing the power, God's power through prayer. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm going to unleash, amen, unleash. I'm going to unleash the power of God through prayer. Unleashing God's power through prayer. Beginning today, we begin a sermon series for the next 31 days on aiming higher in prayer. Last night, we preached, this is your season to prosper. You will not prosper until you unleash the power of prayer. In this 31 days, God is calling, commanding that you pray. Pray without ceasing. There is power within each and every one of us. greater than we can comprehend. You have a power within you that's greater than the atomic energy above you. Nuclear power, solar power, fossil power, and electric power. You have a power within you because the Bible says, Reverend Mia, greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. Oh, you gotta have it within you. That's why I believe God is tired of weak, wimpy, wobbly, frail, fragile, shaky, powerless Christians that go around weeping and crying all day long when God is saying, have you plugged in to the power within you? The power of God comes from within. Little prayer, little power. If you're looking for much prayer, if you're looking for much power, then you have to do much prayer. Have you prayed today? We're taking this prayer thing as seriously as we can take it. We've established a prayer room outside. Some of us just blew right past the room. Did you stop for a minute, get down on bended knee to pray before you came in? We have a website designed just for prayer to inform and instruct you by way of scripture, the responsibility to pray. Oh my God, maybe somebody knows that prayer changes things. Prayer helps us to find direction in our life, to get our life back in order. Prayer is the most powerful principle that you will find in the biblical text that will lead us to places where we have not been and show us things that we have not seen. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, unleash your power. Today we want to talk about unleashing our power, letting it go. Here we find the content and the context of the text written by James. It's also known as the Proverbs of the New Testament. In this book, it gives you several commands, several proclamations, several thoughts on how to lead and live, Minister Paul, a Christian life. Some of us haven't read the book of James, and we find ourselves moving in the wrong direction because we haven't received instructions on how to live a Christian life. If you're a Christian, then you are supposed to represent something because you represent the glory of God. But how many times have we embarrassed God based on the fact that we're living antithetical to what God has done for us? This text emphasizes the importance of the power of intercessory prayer. Intercessory prayer says, I'm not gonna be so caught up in my own selfish needs and desires and wants that I can't stop to pray for somebody else. Have you prayed for somebody else this month? God is commanding us to unleash the power of prayer. Look at your neighbor and say, unleash it and let it go. Here's my first point. In 2023, prayer causes strongholds to submit to God. Oh, look at your neighbor and say, I'm giving my stronghold to God. You see, the Bible says in James chapter 5, 16, confess your faults to one another. The epistle of James emphasizes the power of the principle of prayer in the life of every believer. Don't you take it for granted. Did you pray before you ate that meal, or did you just simply act like a little dog and start eating without stopping to give praise for what God has given you? Some of us get ashamed or embarrassed to pray. Oh my God, if we had more prayer in the school, we would have less shootings in school. If we had more prayer, hallelujah, in the home, we would have less divorces in the home. Have you prayed this year? The late Miles Monroe, Dr. Miles Monroe said, all that God is and all that God has and may be received through prayer. Everything you need to fulfill your purpose on the earth is available to you through prayer. The power of prayer is the ability to break into new levels in God. We live in a society in America today that finds it acceptable to carry secret sins and to live any way we want to, as if God is not in the room for you. I got some news for you, boo-boo. God is not only in the church, but God is in your living room. God is in your computer. God is everywhere, because the Bible tells me that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Therefore, there's no place you can sneak, hide, or get away from that God doesn't know what you're doing. We got to understand that Christians, some Christians, I'm not talking about everybody here, but some Christians have developed an attitude of, I could care less. I could care less what you think. This I couldn't care less attitude is very noticeable. You may not think we can't see it, but we can see it. And those who have spiritual discernment can tell that you couldn't care less about what you are doing, by the way you act, by the absence of your confession, by the hardship that they often create for other folk. Don't you understand, when you create mess, you don't just create mess for the person in front of you, but you create mess for the people all around you. When you bring stink into the church stinks because you have brought the stink in the church. And so it's sad to say, some claim to be Christians, but apparently couldn't give less to confess that they stole money from the church. You stole the tithes and offering. Hallelujah. Couldn't care less to confess they sinned against the family. Couldn't care less that they continue to privately, hallelujah, privately offer apologies, but they publicly dishonor you on a daily basis. But I stopped by to talk to somebody because you couldn't care less to confess that you don't pray for the stronger faith in God. Don't pray for adoration to God. Don't pray for thanksgiving to God. Don't pray for the forgiveness of God. Don't pray for the Holy Spirit to fall from God. Don't pray for the worship of God. Let known, you don't pray for the church. You don't pray for the pastor. You don't pray for the choir. You don't pray for the... All you want to do is come in and take it, because you couldn't care less. Prayer can break the stronghold. Can I declare it and decree it? I stopped by to tell maybe three people up in here, because prayer changes things. And when you decide to pray, you can break strongholds of secret sin, strongholds of harassment, strongholds of helplessness, strongholds of hypocrisy, strongholds of helplessness. Is there anybody in the house that can testify by your hands and your feet that the Lord was able to break some strongholds that you failed to, that you refuse to bring into your church in 2023, strongholds that you refuse to bring into your family? Hallelujah. Then give God a glory praise. That's why the Bible says, when I kept silent, my bones wasted away through my groaning all day long. For day and night your hand was heavy on me. My strength was sapped as in the heat of summer. You holding on to your strongholds shortened your life expectancy. You holding on to your strongholds cripples the family that you live in. Come out of the closet. Come out of the secret. Confess your sins one to another. Here's my second point. I'm not going to be long with you today. In 2023, prayer expresses dependency on God. Look at your neighbor and say, prayer expresses dependency on God. You got to be dependent on God, because God orders your steps in the Lord. I believe the book of Judges was written because they forgot it was God that brought them out of Egypt. It was God that brought them out of slavery. It was God that brought them out of bondage, but they decided to live any way they wanted to. That's why the Bible says in James 5:16, that ye shall be healed, that the effective fervent prayer of the righteous man and woman availeth much. The problem is, we don't have effective prayer because we're not walking in a Christian walk very effectively. Don't you understand? And then until you get right with God, God can't get right with you. God can't bless your mess.
God can't bless your hypocrisy. God can't bless that which he's not up, that he's not in favor of. There's absolutely nobody that can compare to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He's above all and beyond all and better than everybody else. Although there have been times, many times, when others have been an encouragement to us. And I thank those who are an encouragement to your pastor. But I got to declare that even though they helped us through 2022 in difficult times, we have to understand you have been there when we needed somebody to talk to and needed someone to care for us and needed somebody to pray for us. Yet, when it comes down to it, when it comes down to the bottom line, there ain't nobody like Jesus. We depend on Jesus to hear our prayer. Hallelujah. I'm 68 years old. I'm getting tired of folk who lying about their age. Hallelujah. If you're 68 years old, you got to say thank you, God, because every time I wake up in the morning and I think about those that have gone beyond me, I got to say praise God from whom all blessings flow, because I know that I've been to so many cemeteries, but God yet kept us alive. Somebody give God glory. There may be some snow on your furnace. There may be some snow on your roof, but there's a whole lot of fire in your belly. If there's fire in your belly for the Lord, I dare you in the name of Jesus, come out of your stuff, come out of your stuff, come out of your sadness, come out of your weakness. You need to get up and give God glory because Jesus woke you up this morning. Come on, make some noise, everybody over 60. And if you're under 60, you need to thank God that you're yet alive. Come on, give God glory. The longer we live and the older we get, the more we depend on him. We depend on him to give power to intercede for others in prayer, to give healing needs to sick bodies in prayer, to give wisdom needs to solve problems. We depend on him to give a blessed assurance, to stay calm in the midst of a confusion in prayer, to give strength to the needy in order to carry the heavy loads. We depend on him to give the ability to fulfill the responsibility of prayer. We depend on him to keep the doors of the church open. Come here, hallelujah, and say it. If my people that are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and will heal their land. Is there somebody up in this house that can humble yourself and give God a prayer right now? Is there somebody up in this house that can loose all your thoughts and give God a prayer? Did God pray for you this year? Then God needs a prayer from you, because the effect of fervent. Y'all about to cause me a heart attack up here. Y'all sit down. This is my last point, then we're going home. And you'll understand why this thing moves me. My third point is unleash. Somebody say unleash. God's power in prayer. Repeat after me, there's power in prayer. Look at your neighbor and say, there's power in prayer. Look at your other neighbor and say, there's power in prayer. Then look onto the hills and say, unleash it, God, in me. Unleash it, unleash it. That's what the Bible says, Elias. In the NIV, it says, Elijah was a man subject to like passions as we are. Sometimes we look up at this pulpit and act like we ain't with sin. I got some news for you. All these little funny robes that we wear cover the hypocrisy of that we live by. And I thank God that he forgives us, because it would be impossible for us to preach. It would be impossible for us to sing, because somebody prayed for us. Don't you look up here and think we're perfect. And he prayed earnestly that it might rain. It rained not on the earth by the spaces of 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again. And the heaven gave rain. And the earth brought forth her fruit. I get problems with the challenge that if you're going to pray for rain, if you're going to pray that the rain comes down,
Yet you come to church and you don't have an umbrella that you're carrying with you. Hallelujah. I got some challenges when you pray to God for a new job and you didn't buy a new suit for the job that God is about to give you. I got some news for you. If you didn't pray for God to lift you from a sick bed and you don't find yourself giving God thanks in advance, then I question your Christianity, because they tell me that we pray, and when we pray, God hears our prayer. Is there anybody up in this house that can declare that God heard my prayer and I'm sitting here there because God heard my... Oh my God. Y'all messing me up, because I got to get back to what I wrote. The story tells about the healing and resurrection of the son of the widow of Zarephath. Elijah triumphed over the priest of the Baal of Mount Carmel. Mount Carmel, God burned up the offering, even though the altar was soaking, hallelujah, wet. And Mount Carmel, God defeated the 450 Baal worshipers. And Mount Carmel, it hadn't rained for 3 years. Hallelujah. But Jesus, I'm sorry, God in Jesus Christ caused the rain to fall down. It called down on the just and the unjust. Elijah experienced the power of God. I want to know if there's anybody in this house that wants to experience the power of God, because sometimes we act like some whippy, wobbly Christians. But in 2023, you have within you a power beyond your comprehension, beyond your wildest imagination, beyond what your mama and your daddy thought, beyond what your haters have been talking about. We have a power to change the world. We have to exercise the power that God has given us to change things on earth as well as in the spirit realm. Can I prophesy to maybe three of y'all today? Can I give you what God told me to say? I want to prophesy in 2023. We got to unleash God's power through prayer in 2023. We got to unleash God's power for victory. We have to unleash God's power to prosper. We have to unleash God's power to receive a blessing. We have to unleash God's power to pray. Hallelujah. Is there somebody up in this house that can declare, I'm unleashing, hallelujah, the power to heal my people, the power to heal my family, the power to save my sons, the power to save my children, the power to save my marriage, the power for your church to grow, the power to feed the hungry, the power to heal the hunger, hallelujah, the power to clothe the naked. Y'all act like you don't understand what I'm talking about, because when I'm glad that my mama prayed for me, I'm glad that somebody prayed for me when I didn't finish school on time, when I was trying to take every substance that any dealer would offer me, when I was homeless, when I was out on the street, my mama said, I'm not going to give you no money, but I'm about to give you something that is more powerful than money. I'm getting ready to give you a prayer. My mama started praying for me. It cleaned my life up. I've been sober for 40 years. It cleaned my life up. I finished school at 65. It cleaned my life up. I accepted my call to preach. It cleaned my life up. I'm standing here as a living witness. When I was sinking deep in sin, my mother prayed for me. When I was far from the peaceful shore, very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more, but the master of the sea heard my mother's despairing cry, and the waters lifted me. I'm saved because somebody prayed for me. Am I talking by myself? You didn't get here by yourself. Somebody prayed for you. You need to give God glory. You need to give God praise. You didn't get saved by yourself. Somebody drug you to church. Somebody prayed for you in church. You need to give God glory. Somebody helped you. Somebody delivered you. Now you need to give one more prayer. You need to give one more prayer. Your praise is your prayer. I dare you in 2023. Give God a prayer in praise. Unleash your praise. Unleash your praise. Unleash your prayer. Lift up your hands. Throw your hands up. Pick your feet up and give God a glory praise. I dare you in the name of Jesus, on the count of three, run down to this altar
and touch it in the name of Jesus. One for the Father, two for the Son, three, let's get ready. Run down here and touch God. Run down here and touch the Savior. He's here. He's here. He's here. He's here. Praise Him. Glorify Him. Lift Him. Love Him. Feel Him. Release. Let it go. Unleash your power. Unleash your praise. Unleash it in the name of Jesus. Unleash it in the name of Jesus. Touch this altar. Touch this altar. Touch this altar. Touch this altar. Release. Relive. Revive. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Now give Him one more praise offering. Praise Him that you love Him. Praise Him that you adore Him. Praise Him because He forgave you. Praise Him because He cleaned you up. Praise Him. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor. Give him a high five. Tell them to unleash their power. Look at your other neighbor. Give them a high five. Tell them to unleash your power. There's healing in the house. There's forgiveness in the house. There's joy in the house. There's love in the house. Because you unleashed the power of prayer in your praise. Hallelujah. 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 Please stand. Please stand. God told me to give you one more prophecy. That whatever God took from you in 2022, God's going to give you greater in 2023. Come on, give God glory. You got to believe it. Reach up in the air and just grab it for yourself. It ain't me, but it's God. Grab it for yourself. Yes, yes. Come on, choir. Why don't you praise Him?
Praise Him.
Come on and praise Him.
His name is Jesus.
Precious Savior.
Precious Savior.
Oh, He's worth it. Somebody said from the rising.
From the rising.
From the rising.
Somebody said from the setting.
Unto the glory.
Unto the glory.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus.
He's worthy. Yes, He is.
Worthy.
Jesus is worthy.
Worthy.
Oh, yeah. He's worthy. Just listen to the words. Listen to the words.
Let's praise. Come on, church, lift your hands and praise Him. And give Him the glory, praise Him. Nobody but Jesus.
Don't take it for granted. Listen to the words. Oh, He's worthy. We open up the doors. There's somebody here that has not been saved. What do I mean by that? You have not been delivered to where you can testify about what God has done for you. A lot of us are in church, but we come into church harboring secret sins. We come into church holding on to private and secret, hallelujah, behaviors. But when you are saved, that means you are delivered from that which has enslaved you, that which has caused you to feel bad about yourself. And God is saying, if you feel a sense of slavery, it doesn't matter if it's debt, it doesn't matter if it's disappointment, it doesn't matter if it's anxiety. God is saying, come out of your seat and come down to be delivered. Come down to be saved. Come down to be set free. For whom the Lord has set free, indeed is set free. I want to know one more thing. Here's the second thing. If you don't have a church home that can preach you, hallelujah, into heaven, that can preach you into knowledge of the Most High God, that can preach you into a Christian lifestyle that is acceptable to God, hallelujah, then we open the doors for you. Here's my third. My third is, if you have not been baptized, if your son or your daughter has not been baptized, if you have not been baptized, the choir's gonna sing. And then if you're not saved, if you don't have a church home and you have not been baptized, we beckon you, we command you to come out of that place and come down to the cross of Jesus. Somebody give God a praise clap, because I believe God is going to send somebody today. Blessed Savior. Hallelujah. Come on, London.
Jesus.
Come on out of your seat.
Yes, Savior.
Come on out of your seat. Whoa, he's worthy. Oh, oh, oh. Is there one?
God is my rock.
He's my light. Baptism.
A strong deliverer.
Join the church. If you lift your hand, I'll come to you. Deliver us from anything that's holding us. I think I see one. Come on, give God glory.
Come on and praise.
If you haven't been baptized, I see one coming.
Give it the glory.
I see another coming. Come on, give God glory. Come on, I believe there's another.
Jesus,
whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Come on, let's say it again. God is my rock.
God is my rock.
Hope of salvation.
Hope of salvation.
He'll save.
Is there another? There
He's
another.
A strong deliverer.
A strong deliverer.
Whoa, he's Jesus.
Can't
give
my Lord.
Come on, come on, come on. He is.
That's why we pray.
Oh, we praise him.
In the morning time.
Praise him.
In the noonday. Late in the evening. Praise him.
Come on, give God one more hand clap of praise. I got two here. Patricia Harris. Come in. Patricia Harris, she comes up to me today and she say, Pastor, I'm coming to join Reid Temple. Come on, give God glory for her. Do you accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior? She said, yes, with all due confidence. Come on, give God praise. Welcome to Reid Temple. Now, we have one more step. We're going to take you into the Jeremiah room so that we may pray and that you may have a better understanding of the institution that you are joining. By the way, we're the best church in all of DMV. Come on, y'all, give God glory. Ain't no better church. I'm not putting them down. Do we have one more? Now, her name is Victoria Brown. Victoria, come here, baby. Now,
No, Victoria, how many children you got?
Two girls.
And Victoria, you saying, I'm looking at it, but I'm gonna let you say it. You can take your mic off. Oh God, you're crying. I need, can I get some women to come up here right now just to lay hands on her, because I just come quickly, just maybe three or four. Come on, quickly. Come on, three or four, amen. Amen. I believe they're tears of joy. She's celebrating because she says her baby's going to be baptized here at Reid Temple. Come on, give God glory. Rem Dubai, pray with her.
Father, we come right now in the name of Jesus, because you are a good God and you're a great God, and you do all things well. You declare the end from the beginning and everything in between. So we thank you from the very time you said, let there be light. You knew that this day, New Year's Day, 2023 would come, and that her children will be baptized. But I thank you, God, because not only will her children be baptized this year, children throughout this church will become baptized. Children will come back to their parents right now. Parents will come back to their children. Husbands and wives will come back together in the name of Jesus. And those who call to Reid Temple AME Church will come asking, what must I do to be saved and how can I serve? Because prayer has already started changing things. In Jesus' name, amen.
Victoria also comes to accept Jesus Christ. I extend the right hand of fellowship. Come on, let's give God glory. Please take them in the back. Everybody to your feet. Everybody to your feet. Has this been a good, happy New Year experience? Come on, give God glory. Remain standing. Our country is in desperate need of prayer. I wish Sister Carmen Hawkins were here, but I'm not sure where she is. Is she Carmen Ford? Is she? Where's Carmen Ford? Come here, Carmen, please, quickly. Carmen Ford is a steward in the church. She is in her first training moment. It's called a board of admissions for ministry. A couple of months ago, come here, please. Amen. Number one, she is a high-ranking corporate executive for human resources. I present you Carmen Ford. Give God praise. Carmen Ford comes to pastor about a few months ago as a new minister. And she said, what?
We need to pray. I said, I asked if we could have a prayer meeting. And from that has come 31 days, which is a team effort. Sister Jamie is a key part of it. Sister Keisha Brody is a key part of it. Reverend Denise, Reverend Keisha Rhodes Smith, Reverend Vivian. This has been a team effort. And it is my pleasure to be a part of this.
I want you to hear something. Carmen says, let's do it. And you've seen this church transformed because somebody stepped out of the darkness into the light. Come on, let's give God praise for the glory of Sister Carmen. That's what we're looking for. Hear what we're saying. This is your church. This is your ministry. Don't let anybody derail what God has destined for you. In 2023, we're going to go higher in the Lord. We're going to go greater in the Lord. We're going to go better in the Lord. Come on, give God a glory praise. We're about to end. Come here, Reverend DeBaye Thomas's husband. Come here, Reverend Thomas. Come here. This is Reverend DeBaye. Come here, Reverend Thomas. Be obedient. Come here, Reverend Thomas, Dr. Thomas. Dr. Thomas is one of the leading scholars in the United States. Give him a hand clap of praise, y'all. Dr. Thomas is married to the effervescent Reverend Dubai Sababo Thomas. Somebody say, pray for him. But I'm gonna tell you something. I look at him as a mentor because he's pastored for over 30, almost 40 years. Come on, give God praise. And his son is in ministry, leading a charge here in the second district. Come on, give God glory. It's called Bethel AME Church in Selma, North Carolina. He put in a plug. He took his mask down. Take your whole mask off because you're getting ready to do the benediction. I present to you Reverend Pastor Hallelujah Thomas. Come on, give God praise.
Let's give a hand of praise to God for Pastor Whitlock and his lovely wife. I have gone through 42 years of ministry, and what the pastor did just a moment ago is what I've lived through. People introduced me as the husband of Reverend Dr. Dubai Thomas, and they don't know my first name. My first name is Michael. Amen. I have entered into this day having some medical challenges. And last night, the Lord gave us a blessing. And so I have an appointment for my doctor on the 18th. And I've begun through the prayers, as you say, to see some changes. Thank God. Now, Reid Temple, you do not understand and know how blessed you are to have a pastor, I should say pastors, like these two. You are tremendously blessed. And I've seen over my 42 years, pastors come and go because their intentions were not for the people. I just said something. The two of them have expressed such tremendous intentions for the Reid Temple family. And I thank God for my wife of 42 years. Let us join hands.
Wait a minute. Father, in the name of Jesus. Last night, he wasn't sure if he was going to live. His chest felt like an elephant was stepping on it. His mind was twirling 1,000 miles an hour. Life flashed in front of him. But his wife said, it's going to be all right. She started praying. She started laying on hands. He believed. Oh God, he is the reflection of the effective, fervent prayer of the righteous, availeth much. So God, when he goes to the doctor, we're already going to say, God, he's healed, he's whole, he's made better. Because in this sanctuary, we know that God is able to deliver us from any elephant on our chest, any mind that is spinning, any life that is out of control. Because by your stripes, we are healed in Jesus' name. Let the church say amen. Amen. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow.
God, our Father, pour out your blessing of 2023 upon your people. As we receive the word, help us to live the word. We ask this all in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Let the people of God sing.